Number five is Rusted Bone, the French movie with Marion Cotillard.
Très bien.
Très bien.
But
have you seen that?
No, I haven't. Of course not. Wait, am I
zero
for
actor?
Six?
Wait a minute, yeah, zero for six.
I just keep my nose to the grindstone and
you're hardworking.
Don't get out much.
They don't get out of the theater. They don't let you out. It's just, I mean, I was just so lucky to have bumped into him that night, and voila, you've got this whole television show about movies.
Hey.
And your career.
Lord works mysterious ways,
well, I just,
bringing us together.
I know. I just thought, well, you know, what are we going to talk about for 26 minutes? And I thought, oh, we'll talk about The Year Stand Best. So, number five with Marion. She was just incredible in it. Utterly a performance with no vanity whatsoever. No.
She plays a double amputee, right?
Right. No makeup, no hair styling, no legs, you know, and she is moving beyond words as a whale trainer, yeah, an orca trainer, duh, but anyway, she's trailing whales by going, raising her arms and going like this, and she, one day, one of the whales bites her legs off, and then she's a double amputee for the rest of the movie, and she does it, she really, really does it.
Nomination?
Yeah, I think so. I helped her get the win before. And when I saw, the last time I saw her, she came running up to me across a crowded room, a press room, and kissed me. Yes, she did. Of course I'm voting for her, right? If I was in the Academy, which I'm not. Number four is Hitchcock.
Good film.
I've seen it three times. Three times.
What?
Okay. You've not seen it either.
Right? I haven't. No. Well, I've seen some Alfred Hitchcock movies.
Well,
does that count?
Which Hitchcock movies have you seen? We can talk about that.
Birds, Rear Window is phenomenal. Of course, Psycho.
I watch his movies over and over.
But tell me about Sir Anthony Hopkins and
hilarious.
Dame Ellen Mirren.
And she's awesome.
Yeah.
As the husband, I mean, his wife was a great force in his life and a great creative force in all his films. Everything he did, he ran through by her. She made the decision, yes or no, like, do you think this will be a good book, you know, and, you know, make a good movie? And she said no, he wouldn't do it. And she was a film editor and edited most of his films and or contributed to the editing and was also a writer.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, there's a lot of Psycho that was written by her.
No kidding.
And I was watching another movie of Hitchcock's, which perhaps you heard of it, Stage Fright.
I haven't, no.
It's the one he made in England after the war. He came back. He went to Hollywood and did Rebecca. That won an Oscar. But he actually never won an Oscar. But I think Dame Helen Mirren is going to get nominated for playing Alma. I'd love it if Sir Anthony was going to, too. But, you know, he gave out a speech saying that the Oscar campaign, like what I'm doing right now, is bullshit.
Mm.
So that may have just eliminated him.
Mm.
But did I take it personally? Of course. Not anyway. Hitchcock, hilarious, great.
Number four,
and number three is Compliance, which I have to say. Okay, I have to say, can you reach that orange scarf over here? This is called special effects. Aunt Dowd gave me this scarf. Aunt Dowd, the star of Compliance, who I've been helping with her Oscar campaign, and it's been working.
Great.
So now I'm not only the Oscar messenger, I'm an Oscarologist, I'm an Oscar strategist, too. And I should be making $50,000 a year for this, I was Ann told me. But I'm not.
Next time.
Next time.
We'll see how Ann does.
Yeah, I mean, if she gets nominated,
tell me about the performance. You said it's very...
Oh, my God. It's
shocking.
It's
movie.
Incredible. And it was at Sundance, it was at the Joville Film Festival in France, and she plays the manager of a fast food restaurant, whose name is Sandra, like not anything as elegant and charming as Tavola, where we are today. We have to say we're at Tavola. We have to keep plugging Tavola, which I haven't been doing. Sorry. 9th Avenue and 38th Street. It's brand new. And we're very happy to be here. But Anne is in this horrible greasy spoon in the middle of nowhere, Ohio, one of those states with all those vowels in them. And that's not where you're from, are you?
I'm from Pennsylvania.
Oh, well, anyway, Compliance is fast food restaurant. She gets this call. She's the manager from somebody she thinks is the police telling her that one of her most attractive waitresses has been stealing and dealing drugs, and could she hold her there in the storage room until the police get there, mm-hmm. and then the film takes off from there. I don't want to give anything more away, but she's on the phone. She's like, you know, she's complying with everything he tells her to do, which keeps getting more and more and more unbelievable.
Right. Based on true story.
Yes. Yes, this is all true. And there was like 70 cases of this all over the country.
Woo.
And number two is cool. Anna Karenina.
Looks so beautiful.
And the beautiful Keira Knightley. Oh, they've all been on my show. I love
that.
Her.
I watched your interview with her twice. But it looks
beautiful. I've watched it about 200 times.
She is stunning and just so
photogenic,
graceful
and all those things. Yeah.
Present. Mm. I will definitely be catching that. And number two.
Number two. That was number two. The rethought version of Anna Karenina. The radically rethought. Joe Wright did a wonderful
job.
Set it in a theater, which I'm sure you could relate to. I'll bet you haven't seen it, but he's taken the book, instead of setting it all over Russia,
mm-hmm.
he set it in an old theater and with some Russian exteriors, but mostly it's in the theater. It's just this stunning trompe l'oeil thing. Coup de théâtre, as they say, and my number one is Les Miserables.
Voilà.
Thank you. Voilà. Do you sing?
Yes.
Oh, you do? You could be in that.
On a good day.
On a good day?
In the moonlight.
All right. I'll take you up on that. Yeah, I used to sing, too. I had a rock group called Stephen Holt and the Boys.
I'm trying to get mine back together. What'd you play?
I was the vocalist.
Nice. Let's do it. Play alto sax. I sing. We found a drummer.
Whoa, an alto sax. Wow. Mm. Okay.
Les Mis.
I've seen it four times. Once in IMAX, once with that special THX sound, and two press screenings, one of them an Academy screening, and people are applauding throughout, like it was a play.
Right.
Like on Broadway.
Stand-up performances?
Oh my God, Anne Hathaway. Hugh Jackman as the lead, Jean Valjean.
He's
Eddie Redmayne, my friend, my BFF, Eddie Redmayne, has been on the show twice for my weekend with Marilyn. He's now like the flavor of the year. And we're rooting for Eddie, we're rooting for Anne, we're rooting for Hugh. All of them to win Best Picture, but they're up against... Argo.
It's a slaughter. It's a fight out there.
Yeah, it's Lincoln, Argo, Zero Dark Thirty, Life of Pi.
Honorable mentions. Any of these for top tens?
Oh well, they're all gonna. No. They're not in it, but Les Mis is in it to win it. And I want to say thank you today to Matthew Goodrich for being here today all the way through at Tavola on the Stephen Holt Show. Isn't this a great place?
It is, yeah.
It's charming. It's sort of like got an Art Deco-y kind of feel, but yet it's got the classic thing going on and the food and that, you know.
Wood burning.
The pizza, fish, unbelievable. Anything you want. Perhaps you'll stick around and have some wonderful
food with us.
In any case, catch Matthew in Picnic, and if he's not on the night you see, go up to the house manager and complain, okay?
I didn't send you.
But anyway, what is that gorgeous understudy going to go on finally? You know, you probably, with the way the weather is in New York and the way people get sick this time of year, you're probably going to be going on. If you don't call me.
I will. He'll call you, and then he'll call everybody else.
All right. Yes, absolutely. Matthew Goodrich, thank you
Stephen,
for being here today.
My pleasure.
On the Stephen Holt Show and lighting up Tavola. Have a fabulous...
Go Irish.
Or in this case, Italian, actually.